dedicated to the cause of interdenominational and worldwide evangelism. So read the cornerstone of Aimee Semple McPherson's mammoth 5,000-seat Angelus Temple when it opened its doors on January 1, 1923. It was no accident that the founder of the Foursquare Church was so focused on the Great Commission. As a young farm girl, the 17-year-old Aimee had married the dashing and dedicated Robert Semple, and together they had committed their lives to missionary service in China. But it was not to be. Aimee watched her dream shatter as Robert suffered and died of malaria shortly after they had arrived in China. Aimee returned to America as a widow and a single parent, giving up any hope of ever ministering the gospel. She married Harold McPherson and tried to settle down to a domestic lifestyle, but it proved impossible. Aimee threw off the comforts of home, packed up her two children, and set off to evangelize America at a time when women could not even vote, and a woman preacher was unheard of, and in some quarters, even unthinkable.
But every day and every night, Jesus spoke to my soul, "Now will you go? Preach, preach, preach the word of God."
Despite the obstacles, Aimee would not give up. She had answered the last call of all, and it would soon take her to the booming city of Los Angeles. She arrived with nothing but a gospel car, as she called it, $100, and a tambourine. It was 1918. There were only 500,000 people in L.A. when Aimee got here, but within the next 10 years, the city would triple in size. Sister Aimee, as she was often called, grew in popularity and in the number of people her ministry was impacting for God. Every Sunday, more than 16,000 jammed into Angelus Temple to hear the evangelist proclaim the gospel.
That meeting started off a half an hour before church with a 50-piece or more silver band. Then you got two big choirs, one on each side, and a song service. They would almost make your hair stand on it. I mean, that thing would just rock.
And then over on the side, Sister McPherson would walk down a long ramp that led down to the platform. She usually carried a bouquet of roses, huge bouquet of roses, and she walked to the platform and walked out, and I thought, that's the most beautiful woman I ever saw in my life. Now, up to this time, women leaders were very plain, very conservative in their dress, and they had to look holy. Mm-hmm. And Sister McPherson was out here in the West where there were movie stars and where there were all kind of people that looked attractive, and she realized that women preachers didn't have to look like last year's warmed over biscuit, you know, but that they could look up to date, nice, have a nice hairdo, look nice and wear stylish clothes. She didn't have a mannish voice or a squeaky woman voice. She had just the most pleasant voice that captivated you. When she'd start to talk, you just sat forward and said, this woman's saying something important.
Friends, I'll tell you, it's a thriller to be a preacher. Why don't every one of you folks get converted and give your heart to God and come on and help me get the world born into the kingdom of Jesus Christ?
Life begins at Foursquare. With salvation, the baptism of the Holy Spirit, divine healing, at the second coming of the Lord. Are you a Christian? Are you born again? Does anyone know that you're saved? Let the world know that you're on the Lord's side. If you're a soldier of the King and a soldier of the cross, then fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life. The next thing you need is a baptism of the Holy Ghost. It isn't enough to be merely born again. You need to grow in God. Grow up to be men and women filled with the Spirit, glorifying God. Otherwise, you're a cold iceberg. Do you see a door there? Do you see what's on the door? There's a Foursquare emblem, the torch, with a lighted flame. It means a Pentecostal baptism of the Holy Ghost according to Acts 2:4. And for all who are cold church members, I advise you to enter that door and see what the Lord does for you. First go in by the door of the cross, then go in by the door of the torch. Get the fire within your soul. One thing I found about the baptism of the Holy Spirit will make you willing to live or die or suffer for Christ. Oh, God, give us men and women who'll have life begin at Foursquaredom, who'll go through the door of the holy torch, be filled with the fire of the Holy Ghost, Acts 2 and 4, and then willing to lay down their lives for the gospel's sake. Amen.
Aimee Semple McPherson used everything at her disposal to tell people about Jesus. She staged elaborate musicals and produced scores of illustrated sermons to dramatize gospel truths. She became the first woman to receive a broadcast license, and soon her radio converts were more numerous than those who heard her in person. But Aimee was more than just an outstanding promoter of the gospel. She was also in touch with its power to change even the most desperate human condition. Every Sunday, hundreds came to be prayed for. Many of them left with a new body as well as a new heart.
And I saw they were coming on crutches, they were coming on all kind of braces. And the thing that took my mind as a little girl was a little boy that came on the platform. And I remember Sister McPherson putting her arm around this little boy. And she said, "Honey, Jesus wants you to see." And she said a simple little prayer there. And immediately that little boy started screaming, "I can see, I can see."
During the Great Depression, the Angelus Temple Commissary fed over 1.5 million people, providing clothing and emergency care to the desperate of Los Angeles. In fact, Foursquare relief programs became far more reliable than the city's own welfare system. Aimee Semple McPherson founded the International Church of the Foursquare Gospel to extend the work she had begun far beyond the boundaries of her own Angelus Temple congregation. On a bright summer day in 1927, the first Foursquare missionary set sail for the Philippines. Within the next year, he would be followed by teams to Panama, China, Czechoslovakia, Bolivia, South Africa, Puerto Rico, Australia, Armenia. In fact, over 20 teams would stake their claim for God in 14 countries in those next few months. Today, the Foursquare Global Assault Force blankets some 67 nations with the gospel, pushing back the darkness of our world wherever they go. For them, as well as for you, the words of Aimee Semple McPherson, penned more than six decades ago, yet remain as the vision and call of God. Aimee wrote in her Bridal Call magazine on January 1, 1928, "You don't need to be an orator. What God wants is plain people with the good news in their hearts who are willing to go and tell it to others. The love of winning souls for Jesus Christ sets a fire burning in one's bones. Soul winning is the most important thing in the world. All I have is on the altar for the Lord, and while I have my life and strength, I will put my whole being into the carrying out of this great commission." May that be said of us as well, and may we too hear the call to serve the hurting and dying of our world as much as a young teenage farm girl named Aimee, who dared to say yes to the last call of all.